Arts program, and I will be making a spicy chicken stir fry.
All right, so welcome back to the Culinary Demo Kitchen. My name is Macy, and I'm gonna make you guys a spicy chicken stir fry. For those at home who have never heard of what stir fry is traditionally known in Asian cuisine, where you have a big wok, something similar to this, but traditionally it's made out of this metal, and it's a lot higher, and it has two little metal handles. And you heat your stove up super, super high on heat, so you can just toss your ingredients in and have it all laid out like I have before you. And you just toss in that high heat, throw in your thickening agent, and then you just serve it right away. So today's portion, I'm going to be making about enough portions for two people, unless you're like me and you really like stir fry, then dinner for one. All jokes aside, let's get started. So first thing you wanna do is wash your hands, which I previously did beforehand. And you're gonna wanna put on your gloves to make sure that you are quite sanitized, because you will be working with a lot of ingredients. So first things first, that is very important to making a stir fry, is preparing your slurry. Now, slurry is your thickening agent that makes your liquid sauce become thicker. Of course, the results vary on how much of the slurry that you will need. So here today, I have 1 tablespoon of cornstarch, 2 tablespoons and a half of water. And depending on how thick you want your slurry is depending on your personal preference. I have here with me a fork just to mix it all up. And you'll feel at the bottom, you'll see that the top is very liquidy, and at the bottom you can feel that it's a little bit thicker on the bottom, and that is just perfect. All right, let's leave this right here. I'm gonna prepare the stir fry sauce ahead of time. So with a stir fry sauce, you wanna have about roughly a tablespoon of honey to give it just enough sweetness. You want about 1.5 tablespoons of soy sauce. You want to add 1/2 tablespoon of sesame oil. And you want to add 1 cup of chicken broth. And for those who like a little kick to their dish, you have about 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder, depending on how spicy you like it. If you like to have dragon's breath, I would highly recommend adding a lot more. And you want to mix this all up until the honey dissolves at the bottom here. First things first is you're going to want to turn on your stove to quite a high heat. And you're going to want to add enough oil that it just coats the pan just nicely. With this specific technique, it is known in Asian cultures as dry frying your meat. So right here, you want to make sure that you keep your meat cold. Right now I have it in a little bit of an ice bath. And I have chicken meat that has been cut to a small dice. And you want to add just a little bit of salt for taste, some pepper, salting the meat allows it to marinate and bring out the flavors and also bring out some of the moisture that is inside the meat. Want to remember to mix it. If you're at home, mix it in your skillet to make sure you distribute that oil evenly. You'll be able to start seeing ripples inside your oil, and that's when you know when your pan is hot enough. All right. Take off the gloves here. It should roughly take about 3 to 5 minutes, depending on how big and how much meat you're cooking. If you have to, you can always turn it down a notch just in case to make sure that you don't burn the bottom of your pan here or your chicken. And right now what I'm doing is I'm letting the first portion of this sit down for the chicken so that it creates a Maillard reaction, which is the browning of the sugars. So dry frying is a technique known in the Asian culture where it is a meat that is not deep fried or is pan fried, but instead it is wok fried because it's not using a lot of oil, it's just using just enough. Behind me, I'm just going to quickly rinse out that bowl. And you'll want to make sure when you're cooking your meat not to press down on your meat, as it can actually press out the moisture that's inside the chicken or inside the meat of your desire. Depending on the amount of stir fry ingredients that you have. A stir fry is not just two vegetables, you can also do a fruit stir fry as well with taro and strawberries and so much more. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to toss in my broccoli that I've carved blanched, which is cooking the broccoli in water for half its cooking time so it's not too soft. Toss it right in. And then you cool it. I'm going to toss in a cup of my carrots here that I have cut into a quarter, half an inch dice. I have my half a cup of mixed peppers. I have my red peppers that, once again, have been in my half inch dice. Start tossing those vegetables around. We have even cooking distributed. If needs be, if you think that the bottom of your pan is going to be cooking too high of a temperature or you feel like you don't want to burn your ingredients, right here I have chicken broth since I'm making a chicken stir fry, just in case so it doesn't burn my ingredients so you don't have that black char to the bottom of them. Alright, and you want to cook your vegetables until they're about al dente, which is two in the tooth, or until you can stab them with a fork. Traditionally in my culture, since I am Chinese, I actually tend to add liquid to my stir-fry ingredient to help steam the vegetables from the bottom up, just so it helps it with cooking, and it prevents it from burning the bottom of your pan. This also helps create a small sauce to help with your other sauce that you'll be making. Because I added the chicken broth liquid, you can always turn up your heat all the way to high. This, once again, should take about, depending on how big your dices are and how much you have your ingredients, take about 2 to 3 minutes. In my case, where I have quite a bit of ingredients, it should take me about another 2 or 3, maybe even 4 minutes. Put this on the side here. You want to remember to season your vegetables as well. Season everything as you go. Don't forget that you also did season your chicken, so you don't want to add too much. The carrots are starting to become a little bit darker. Alright. So, to make your stir fry sauce, you want to remember to mix it just to make sure that all that honey on the bottom is dissolved. Remember to mix. Make sure that all your ingredients have the flavor of stir-fry sauce. This is when you add it back in your meat of choice. When making a stir-fry, the main important thing is your sauce. Alright, so right here I have minced up garlic and ginger. Slurry, which may have separated around this time, and you want to gently stir it and throw it right in. This is when you gotta stir to make sure that everything thickens up for your stir fry. You can plate it with rice, you can plate it with wonton noodles, I'll plate this with lo mein, whatever your heart really desires.